For Lark's head knot, the strand is on the front side. Find the center of your cord by folding it in half. From top, slide your loop behind the wooden dowel. Drop the tail ends in front over the dowel. Simply pull the tail ends through the loop from back and secure it tightly. For reverse Lark's head knot, strand is on the back side. Find your center loop just like before, but this time we are going underneath and up. Fold the loop over the dowel in front, pull the tail ends through the loop in front and secure it tightly. In fact, reverse Lark's head knot is nothing but the Lark's head knot seen from behind. On the left you have Lark's head knot, and when you turn it around is what you can see on the right side, which is also known as reverse Lark's head knot. Even you can use a ring for creating these knots. That's how, in the same way, you can create a Lark's head knot. And in the same way, here's your reverse Lark's head knot too. This is the front of the knot and this is the back of the knot. So depending on how you rotate around your object, it lays the actual strand in front or back. To make the Lark's head knot faster, once you find the center loop, this way fold the loop end forward. Insert the dowel through the gaps formed from one end to other and tightly secure the knot. In another faster method, find your center loop and fold it over, and you have your Lark's head knot. Gently slide the wooden dowel through the loop and it's done. For running Lark's head knot, which is commonly used for layering wall hangings, for this you'll need a longer piece of cord. Slide your cord from up and behind your wooden dowel. Bring it across the short tail end and then cross under the wooden dowel by going underneath and up. Down through the loop, ease the slack and secure it tightly. Run it across the wooden dowel. Repeat the same thing again on the other side. Bring cord over top from back of your wooden dowel. Bring it across the running strand. Go up from underneath the dowel, down through the loop and tighten the knot. You'll find it very handy while working on large projects. For vertical Lark's head knot, once you have two Lark's head knot, the horizontal ones, out of these four strands, two outer strands are considered working cords while middle two are filler cords. Pick any side of working cord, pass over and under both the middle filler cords. Pass through the loop and tightly secure the knot. To have a complete vertical Lark's head knot, you need to repeat it once again, but not in the similar fashion over and under. This time, take the cord just the opposite way, under and over the filler cords. Pass through the loop and secure the knot. This way, you will have one complete vertical Lark's head knot on your right side. Here you can clearly see the difference between horizontal Lark's head knot on the top and vertical Lark's head knot on the side. Similarly, you repeat the same on the other side. Same way, when you pick the left side working cord, pass over and under the middle filler cords through the loop and tighten the knot. But the second time, it's not in the same way. Just the opposite, under and over the filler cords, pass through the loop and tighten it. Similarly, continue making such easy vertical Lark's head knots. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.